Hello, my people. Okay, so yeah, let's start. Well, I just sum up the whole video, so if you want to stop here, you can. The question for me today, I'm keep on reading on this thing of machines and how smart can we make a machine, but then is this debate of smart on what? And what has been like the evolution of humankind, and what do we value when we program machines, and what do we know about the brain when we program machines? Because machines are mathematic. I mean, this I just read it, this dataism. So you suppose like everything can be unified in the same type of units, so we can calculate whatever in the same unit, which might make sense, but some things take longer and be transformed and to be translated into different units. So, two of the things that I think are more important about human beings, and I think we are losing them, is, well, one is already lost, which is smell. So we have designed these wonderful machines that process and serve so nicely visual information and oral auditive information. Why? Because our brains are really wonderfully prepared to serve very important and vital information through our eyes and through our ears. Wonderful. We communicate mostly through eyes and ears. Thus, it implies that the more we use and develop technology that focuses on eyes and ears, are behaving in detrimental, are reducing other senses, like the sense of smell, for example, or the proprioception, the sense of knowing where is the body and how we relate with different objects, and the taste. Because, my friends, in our society, we taste even less, we smell even less, and we move even in a more clumsy way, I'm pretty sure. Like, that's the thing. If we compare ourselves with hunter-gatherers, we move worse. We smell worse. Well, we even hear worse. We taste less. That's the thing. And the wonderful example here is, and I read it today, Borna told me on a message on Facebook, if you are following me on Facebook, Borna told me that he smell fear. My friend, you cannot smell fear, but for one reason. The main reason is you are not connected through me in a safe physical environment. Because if you are in a physical environment, my biochemicals that reflect or transmit information that is carrying this emotion of fear can reach your nose. But if we are communicating in a through a machine, the machine is not transmitting smell. It could transmit certain oral patterns that means that I'm afraid. I mean, this is already there, and even machines can start recognizing these things. But not fear, my friend. You cannot smell fear because you are not physically with me. And this is crucial information. Because this is the turn, and it's wonderful that there is no one now. We used to smell fear. We were able to smell fear. And there are still people on the planet that are able to smell fear. But yeah, that's the thing. There are hunter-gatherers that are able to smell up to trillion different things. I don't, well, I don't know the references. I will have to check it. If you are interested, you write me a message and I look it for you, and then I post it. But you can believe me as you wish. I'm reading Homo Deus from Harari, so that's where I get the information. So that's the point. Like, we are losing the smell. And we used to communicate so much information through smell. And that was true. That was real. It was very difficult to lie or to make it faint, to make it false, this type of information. So just give it a thought. Like all the things we are earning or gaining from one side, in cost of which other things? I'm a dancer, I do yoga. So it's part of it. Like, why are we? I mean, why there are so many spiritual techniques that uses smells, for example? Like, why? This is wonderful. This one. If there is any brand that promotes incense, it's not this one because this is a gift. But really, this one is wonderful. So that's the thing. Like when you go to a church and they have this big incense, incense thing that moves from one side to side. I don't know in English how do you call it, incensario. It might help people to get into more spiritual experiences or maybe getting more into the place where they are at that precise moment. For example, this is one. And also, techniques about movement. We have yoga, we have tai chi, and we have stillness. Stillness is movement. I mean, even when we are moving like randomly, we are moving. Hola, Sermal. I'm not saying hi to people. So even when we are randomly moving, we are moving, but it's not conscious. But the point of being still, it's making conscious something that goes unconscious. And this might help us to increase the consciousness. So, my exercises for you, if you want to practice them good, if you want to be more human and less machine, from now to the future, you can try to smell more things. And you can try to move as well, because machines, well, machines are learning to move very fast, like Boston Dynamics. Hello, I'm Carlito Fluito. I mean, they are making amazing things, Boston Dynamics, and we have to recognize it. Like, machines learn really, really fast. But things we don't understand, like it's smell, like it's intuition. How can we program intuition if we don't know what is intuition in ourselves? This is very humane so far. Smell is very humane so far. Because we don't know how to put it in machines. But if we have this feeling of we want to be humans and we don't want to be machines, yet let's focus on the positive aspects of being human, these skills, these abilities that are being in decrement because we are focusing so much. For example, well, I will try to finish soon, but there are so many examples, really. Like, we used to the switch towards more mathematical and more written and reading societies. This, I don't remember where I read it. It seems it has affected negatively on how much can we empathize with people, because we are using parts of our brain that are destined to empathize with people, to have social relationships. Now we are using them to make mathematics. So then I thought, okay, now we have machines, that mathematics is something that they do really nice, really fast. Would it be possible to delegate all mathematical tasks to the machine and focus on smelling, and focus on social relationships, and focus on things that feel good and natural and humane to us? So this is my question, but the point is very complicated, but because many people can say, yeah, but then when a machine starts to be better than you at socializing, because the machine knows you and knows the other person and knows how to compute the information to give you like the perfect romantic couple or the perfect friend. I don't know, but there is something that I know, and is moving is inherently good. We like to move. I like to move. So people, kids like to play. People, kids like to discover things, which is smelling, which is tasting, which is touching. We are in this society now of watching and hearing. And we are not in a society of touching. We are not in a society of smelling, of tasting, of trying the weight of objects. Now I'm too much into Carlos dancing, but I'm a person, so I'm complicated and complex in different parts. So that's my point. Like, why are not we focusing more into more spontaneous human skills? And why, well, this is for another day. Like, why are we becoming consumers instead of producers? I'm not becoming producer and I feel good because I'm making this and I'm sharing and I don't know the impact, but I know there are people that are out there. Adria, thank you very much, because Adria, I know you are there since I know you, and it's already 5 years. So, respect, thank you very much. I don't know who joined, but I'm saying goodbye. So, Homo Aviator, I say hi only at the end. So, thank you, Homo Aviator, for being here. I know you will watch it now. Lemons or itches? Very different. Bye bye. Hello, thank you, Machine, for being there also.